My dear children, welcome to the EBS online class. Hope you all are staying safe at home. Today let's revise lesson 2, Air and Water. In this lesson, we studied about the atmosphere, importance of atmosphere, layers of atmosphere, the composition of atmosphere, properties of air, and also different ways to remove soluble and insoluble impurities from water. What is atmosphere? A blanket of air that surrounds the earth is called atmosphere. And what is the importance of atmosphere? Yes, it contains gases like oxygen and carbon dioxide. Oxygen is needed for all living organisms on earth to breathe. Carbon dioxide is needed by the plants to prepare food. Then atmosphere also helps to keep the temperature of the earth moderate. The ozone layer of the atmosphere absorbs the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun and protects the living organisms on earth. Then we studied about the 5 layers of atmosphere. Which are they? Troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere.
Troposphere is the layer of atmosphere nearest to the earth's surface. It is the only layer in which we can breathe normally, and most weather changes takes place in this layer. Then stratosphere lies above the troposphere. It contains the ozone layer and the jet planes usually fly in this layer. Then above stratosphere is the mesosphere. Meteors burn up in mesosphere. Thermosphere lies above the mesosphere. Then exosphere lies above the thermosphere and fades into the space.
What does air contain? What is the composition of air? Air is a mixture of gases. The most abundant gas in the atmosphere is nitrogen. That is about 78%. 21% is oxygen and 1% is mainly argon. A small amount of carbon dioxide is present, that is 0.03%, but it is very important as it is needed for the plants to prepare food. Apart from this, air also contains water vapor, dust and smog. The amount of water vapor in the atmosphere is called as humidity. Then we studied about the properties of air. We studied this by demonstrating experiments. Hope you remember that. Which are the properties of air? Air occupies space, air exerts pressure, air has weight, and oxygen in the air is needed for burning. These are the properties of air. Then we discussed about different ways to remove soluble and insoluble impurities from water. Which are the different methods to remove insoluble impurities from water? Yes, sedimentation and decantation and filtration.
What is sedimentation? Sedimentation is the method used to remove heavier insoluble impurities from water. Take a glass of water and put some mud in it and stir well. Keep it aside without disturbing for some time. You can see the insoluble mud particles settle down at the bottom of the glass and clear water can be seen on the top. The mud that settles down is known as sediment. This method is called sedimentation. Now carefully pour out the clear water into another glass. The sediment is left behind. This process is known as decantation. The next is filtration. It is the method used to remove insoluble impurities from water using a filter paper. The method of evaporation followed by condensation to remove soluble impurities from water is called distillation. Then we studied about the processes in a water purification plant. Which are the 4 steps? Yes, screening, sedimentation, filtration and chlorination.
That's all in this lesson. Read the textbook very well. Study the notes. See you in the next class. Thank you.